Hello and welcome to the second episode of Path of Hideout. Today I'm going to show you several different ways to build an altar in your hideout. Altars are pretty cool, most people have them, but a lot of them are just plain old boring. The first design here, I've added a few pillars and a fortification wall, as well as the altar and a few urns to add detail. Then I'm going to add a few items inside the altar. The first here is the table from Sana. When inside it looks really cool. You have these orbs moving around. You use a lot of different items. I like the stand lamp because it looks like a chalice. I like the extraction device. The spindle looks kind of cool. You have a saw blade in front. Of course, a golden bust. Whatever you like, you can add inside it. And even a few items does a lot to make the altar less boring. The second design here is very simple. You have two lights, a rostrum, a couple of sarcophagus, and some urns for detail. If you prefer, you can turn off the lights. I often do this because I really like the glow from Katarina. Third one here, I've made like Elrion's private altar with a blessing fund inside the books to show the power of learning. Again, a very simple design that takes a few minutes to make, but it's a lot less boring than a standard altar. Finally, I have Rissi's altar here. This is somewhat more complex, but again, use some pillars in the rear, few arcs, bit of a blood, some corpses, and suddenly you have the perfect altar for Rissi. In my next episode, I'm going to show you how to use red carpet to make blood pools for your hideouts. I'll see you then.